Hello and a very warm welcome, viewers. You're watching the brand new edition of India Fights Back with your host, Kriti Mishra. The UK Health Ministry has said that a new COVID-19 strain called Lambda is more dangerous than the Delta variant. This variant has been detected in more than 30 countries in the past 4 weeks. The strain was first identified in Peru in December last year. Lambda is the dominant variant in the South American country, with 81% samples found to be carrying it. And for deeper insights on this variant, I'm joined by Dr. B.L. Sherwal, Director, Rajiv Gandhi Super Speciality Hospital, New Delhi, and Dr. Mamta Chawla, Scientist F, ICMR, NICED. Welcome to Ratsabha Television, both of you, and thank you so much for joining us. And Dr. Sherwal, coming to you first. The Lambda variant has so far not been found in India or neighboring countries. In Asia, only Israel seems to have reported this variant until now. How much is this a cause of concern for India right now, at least?
No, as of, 14th of June, Lambda has been labeled as variant of interest. So it means it is spreading very fast. So that is a concern, that transmissibility is one of the factors which affect the countries that is larger. Communities, and then it has come to the notice that it is more causing the more severe disease. So that is another issue, and then we have found that as of now, it is also able to escape the immune system. It is also able to escape the diagnostic or available therapeutic means. So that is definitely an issue, not only for India, but in other countries also. We really need to have a close watch on the Lambda variant. And touch wood that till now, we have not reported any case in India. But definitely, because very frequent connectivity is there between the European countries and India. So, there are chances that we may get this variant soon in near future. So, definitely, we have to prepare ourselves. And the first thing is that we have to try that this variant should, as much as we can delay reaching of any strain. So, that is the first thing which country to country it's supposed to do. As of now, all those measures which we are seeing are really, again, time to be stressing that distancing and keeping a close watch on the people who are traveling from the concerned countries, and they should be properly screened, and no person carrying, that may be carrier or the patient, carrying this variant should not be allowed, or they should be, quarantined at the airports, so that this should not spread to the community level. So that is the first thing I think we have to do. And then we have to prepare our machinery and our system to tackle, if at all we get this state. And as it has been reported, that it's very lethal, rather causing mortality more than 10% people who get infection. So that is really a matter of concern, and yes, we have to be alert. And I think government is already taking all precautions provide that.
As you're saying, sir, that we have to be very, very alert and we have to be vigilant. But Dr. Chawla, I'd like to understand that as the WHO says that Lambda variant has at least 7 significant mutations in the spike protein. Help us decode that, ma'am.
Most of the variants of interest or concerns, most of them have mutations in the spike protein. And the spike protein is actually required for receptor binding and entry of virus into the cells. So most of our vaccines are also designed against spike proteins. The Delta variant, which is a VOC and was identified from India, had three new mutations in the spike protein. And similarly, the UK variant also had a mutation in the spike protein. However, this lambda mutant variant, what I say, has seven mutations in the receptor binding region of the spike, in the spike protein. So that is why there is a prediction that there will be increased transmission ability of the virus. So it will be infecting much faster. That is why WHO has pointed out this, that it has seven mutations in the spike protein, and it also considered it as a variant of interest.
Absolutely, ma'am. So as you're telling us about transmissibility and severity, Dr. Sherwal, what is the data suggesting us right now about this variant?
As of now, it has been reported from Peru, and almost one third of the cases had been after the genome sequencing is not causing the European countries also. So that is a issue that because of the transmissibility of the lambda variant. So other concern which has been seen is that whatever the vaccine, like in Peru, they were giving a Chinese vaccine. It has been found that it is being escaping the effect of the neutralizing antibodies, whether it is produced by the infection or by the giving the vaccine. So that is a matter of concern. That is why if we are concerned whether the Covishield or the vaccine, Covaxin or Sputnik V virus vaccine, which we are covering in the Indian population. So that may be, again, our data is not there, but that is coming in the notice that it may avoid the neutralizing antibodies produced by these vaccines as well. But the data is not there. I think the authorities are collecting the data, and whether it is symptoms, whether it is infectivity, whether it is severity of the disease, or whether it is escaping of the immune system. So data is being collected, and then it will be worked on. And initially, as why we are saying that it's more lethal and more concerned about this, because of the, Dr. Mamta had just told, there are spike protein various. So that is a concern, because in the Delta, there are three mutations, but in this lambda variant, there are around seven mutations. So that is a concern. Although it is not must that all those seven mutations are going to cause the concern. There may be only one or two. That is always there. The large number of mutations are there in the new variant. But that is not must that all those mutations which has been taken place from fast infectivity or fast transmissibility from one person to another. So all viruses mutate from time to time, but it is not known that all mutants cause the infectivity increase or toxicity increase. So it is a matter of concern, but at the same time, till the time we have the data, only then we will be able to tell that what is the effect of this coming lambda variant. But definitely, as of the available data, we have seen that it is really found to be very, very fast from transmissible from one person to other or one country to other. It is being seen. So, but more data is required.
So, as you're saying, more data is required, but you also voice concern over transmissibility and severity of it. But Dr. Chawla, right now, the biggest concern would be if it evades our vaccines, then what happens?
The current data does not, we do not have enough data to come to that conclusion right now, because most of the viruses mutate and there are variants which are generated, which may decrease the efficacy to a certain extent, but it is not really necessary that the variant will escape vaccine efficacy completely. So there may be a little less impact. However, at this point of time, it will be too early to say that. Though in the study in Chile, they have found that there were vaccine escape cases with the Chinese vaccine. However, it is still too preliminary to predict. What I think is that most of the vaccines, when a person is vaccinated and develops immunity, the immunity is not against a single, epitope. So the whole spike protein, there may be mutation, but it will not change completely. So that will be so different that the antibodies cannot recognize. The efficacy may go down if as we know, as we will collect the data, as Dr. Sherwal suggested. However, it is not that vaccines won't work at all. It is not, 100% or 0%. With vaccine, we may have little less efficacy or less power compared to the original strains against which the vaccine was developed. But still, I think vaccines will protect against severe disease.
Absolutely, ma'am. So that's a big respite, at least right now. But Dr. Sherwal, as you're talking about the efficacy of vaccine on this new variant, there are also concerns on the testing models. As you've seen earlier also, false negatives. How much do you think that is a cause of worry?
Yes, we have seen even during the second wave that a large number of patients were coming who were having symptoms of typical COVID. But when they were tested for RT-PCR, they were reporting negative. So it is definitely a matter of concern. But I think one thing is that from time to time, our RT-PCR need to be changed accordingly. It is a probe based. I think some probe has to be changed. And then we will be able to detect all the new variants which are there. In addition to that, now there are different type of tests are being coming in the market. So we can try the new modalities. And also lately in the second wave, we have seen the benefit of diagnosis by CT scan through artificial intelligence. And it was quite good. It does not only help in diagnosis, but also help in prognostic value. We can see the score. So that is another thing, and definitely, but we know that if it is clinically appearing like COVID, symptoms are COVID, so clinicians are advised that they should put into the category of suspected COVID and treat them into the COVID facility as presumably COVID. So there is an issue, but we should go ahead as far as treatment part is concerned. So there is no stoppage of that.
Right,
so
sir.
I think,
right, sir.
They should be admitted in the COVID facility and should be treated in the COVID facility.
Right. So that's the suggestion that you're giving for the testing model. Dr. Chawla, what is your take on Dr. Sherwal's suggestion?
I agree with Dr. Sherwal. However, I would also like to add that most of the currently used RT-PCR tests, majority of them actually target two different genes of SARS coronavirus. And the spike protein is usually not there in most of the tests. So most of the tests consist of two genes. It can be RNA-dependent, RNA polymerase, and the E gene, or some tests use N gene, nucleocapsid genes. So most of the mutations in these variants are actually more in spike protein. So, and currently we are focusing on using two different genes of SARS coronavirus so that we at least get signal in, even if there is a mutation or there is some changes in one of the protein, the other protein can give signal and we can identify it as a, you know, possible corona case. So, and in addition to that, CT scan is a very good and test, which actually also tells you the severity of disease.
Yes.
In addition to the positivity or so, but the companies as well as the different diagnostic laboratories, they are all continuously developing the tests. So I'm sure that as new variants have come, the new tests are also coming in market. So we should not be concerned too much about you know, misdiagnosis at this point of time. The more concern is about increased transmission and how we should cope, how we should be cautious in India about it.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. That's a very important point that you're making, that it is a dynamic situation. But Dr. Sherwal, as we're talking about the mutations and the variations, of course, we do not know how the virus is going to behave. This is an uncharted territory. But sir, I know it's a difficult question to ask, but do you think that it can mutate further to become even more dangerous?
See, all the viruses actually, when we talk about not only viruses, even the organisms which are live, so they have this habit of mutation. It is a simple thing that fittest to survive. So there it is a, you know, battle of survival. So all the viruses, if you will try to vaccinate as many people, and then they will find the way to get new host for infections, or will try to escape the immunity gained through vaccination. So it is a simple, from ages, the organism are known to do it. So it is a battle who wins. So we will try that as a human race, we will win the battle against the virus. And it depends how fast.
Yes.
So basically that in addition to the masking, in addition to the distance, in addition to the vaccination, whatever effort we can do it, so that if we do not help the virus to transmit from one host to another, so that virus cannot spread from one person to another person. Basically, it is the human race which we are helping the virus. Once we stop that, then virus definitely will not be able to replicate from, it will not find the new host. And definitely it will be eradicated. Now, usually we find very difficult to eradicate the viruses, but even if it can be of that it loses its infectivity or the severity of the disease, if it becomes a normal like we have seen with the influenza viruses. So till the time that it is causing, mortality of that high magnitude, as of now, they say that 600 deaths per 1 lakh of population, which is huge because of a single disease. So I think we need to have some or the other measures to counterattack the virus. We have to be ahead of the virus to stop the transmission.
All right, sir. And we do hope that we defeat this pandemic very soon. But time for closing comments from both my guests. Dr. Chawla, coming to you first. So far, we've been combating the second wave. We do not know about the third wave. And of course, the constant mutations and the variations. Your word of caution, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm a very optimistic person. So what I would say that we can combat and we can fight the virus by increasing our vaccination. More we vaccinate, the more we try to stop disease severity as well as transmission, as well as we have to follow the COVID protocols which the government advises again and again. So it is, community participation is very important.
Yes.
Unless we as a community participate and follow the protocols, it would be very difficult for any government agencies or him to control any disease. So it is a combination of community as well as government and the medical professionals. Participation of all will help us to defeat the pandemic.
And of course, we have to remember that no one is safe unless everyone is safe. Dr. Sherwal, your closing remarks.
As we are talking about the lambda or a new variant, I always say that we have to be proactive and we have to hit hard. The government has to take action so that first thing is that now we have many diagnostic lab, and also now we are developing the network of the genome sequencing lab.
Right,
so we should keep on doing the genome sequencing in the interest of the finding the new variant as fast as you know, as soon as possible, and so that we can start the containment of the people who are having the this new lambda variant. So I think
right,
we have
sir.
To be very
with that very important point, as you talked about genome sequencing. We'd like to wrap up this show because we're completely out of time. On that note, thank you so much, Dr. Chawla and Dr. Sherwal, for joining us. Well, viewers, that's all we had for you in this edition of India Fights Back. But before that, let me remind you once again to wear your face mask, wash your face and hands regularly, and remember to ensure physical distancing whenever you're stepping outside. Remember, these simple precautions are all it takes to defeat this pandemic. Take very good care and goodbye.